Military transport helicopters have long been a vital component of the US military's operational strategy, becoming a tradition that dates back to the early Cold War era. These helicopters revolutionized military logistics and troop movements, allowing the US military to transport personnel, equipment, and supplies directly into the heart of combat zones and remote areas where traditional vehicles couldn't operate. The introduction of helicopters like the UH-1 Huey during the Vietnam War solidified their place in military history. The success of the Huey paved the way for more advanced transport helicopters. The V-22 Osprey is a true game changer in military aviation, a machine that defies traditional limits. It's not just a helicopter, and it's not just a plane. It's the best of both. With its revolutionary tilt-rotor design, the Osprey can lift off and land in tight spaces like a helicopter, but cruise at high speeds like a fixed-wing aircraft. This unique ability makes it one of the most versatile and powerful assets in the US military's arsenal. The Osprey's capabilities, such as flying at twice the speed of conventional helicopters, with ranges between 270 and 580 miles, proved crucial in diverse military operations, to providing humanitarian aid in disaster zones. The V-22 Osprey is a groundbreaking aircraft that combines the vertical takeoff and landing, or VTOL, capabilities of a helicopter with the high-speed performance of a turboprop plane. This unique tilt-rotor design is what sets the Osprey apart from conventional aircraft, offering unparalleled versatility for both military and civilian applications. The defining feature of the Osprey is its tilt-rotor mechanism, which allows its two large three-bladed rotors mounted on engine nacelles at the tips of its wings to rotate between two distinct flight modes, helicopter and airplane. It typically operates as a helicopter with the nacelles' vertical and rotor's horizontal alignment. Once airborne, the nacelles rotate 90 degrees in as little as 12 seconds for horizontal flight, converting the V-22 into a more fuel-efficient, high-speed and long-range turboprop aircraft. This dual-mode capability grants the Osprey a maximum speed of 315 miles per hour, nearly double that of conventional helicopters. The Osprey is powered by two Rolls-Royce AE1107C Liberty turboshaft engines, each producing over 6,000 horsepower. The V-22's two Rolls-Royce AE1107C engines are connected by drive shafts to a standard central gearbox so that one machine can power both prop rotors. If an engine fails, either engine can power both prop rotors through the wing drive shaft. This redundancy greatly enhances the aircraft's reliability and survivability, especially in hostile environments. The Osprey's airframe is primarily constructed from composite materials to reduce weight while maintaining strength and durability. The fuselage, produced by Boeing, integrates advanced avionics and flight controls, while Bell Helicopter manufactures the wings, nacelles, rotors, and tail surfaces. The wings of the Osprey can rotate to allow for compact storage on aircraft carriers or in tight spaces, a critical feature for naval operations. This wing rotation capability, combined with the tilt-rotor design, provides the Osprey with unmatched operational flexibility. The Osprey employs a triple redundant fly-by-wire flight control system, which reduces pilot workload by automating many of the aircraft's complex operations. The system allows for smooth transitions between flight modes and provides enhanced stability during turbulent conditions. Advanced avionics include a glass cockpit with multifunctional displays that provide critical flight and engine data, and a communications suite that integrates with military networks for coordinated operations. The Osprey boasts an operational range of 270 to 580 miles, depending on its configuration. the V-22 is like a 10-ton cargo helicopter. 24 troops seated, 32 troops floor-loaded, or 20,000 pounds of internal cargo, or up to 15,000 pounds of external cargo with a dual hook could be carried. This allows it to perform a wide range of missions, from troop transport and medical evacuations to cargo delivery and special operations. The UH-60 Black Hawk helicopter, which was named after the Native American war leader of the Sauk tribe in the Midwest, is every bit the fighter its honorable name suggests. The now iconic UH-60 Black Hawk helicopter has been the Army's frontline utility helicopter for the past 40 plus years. The Sikorsky UH-60 is the United States Army's primary medium lift helicopter. It was developed in response to lessons learned by the Army during the Vietnam War, which highlighted the need for faster, more armored rotary wing transport aircraft. The first production UH-60A was accepted by the Army in 1978 and entered service in 1979. Over the years, the helicopter has been modified and upgraded to support evolving missions, such as the HH-60W Whiskey, which has advancements to better support the full range of combat rescue and other special missions. UH-60 Black Hawk helicopters were first used in the invasion of Grenada in 1983, and then again in the invasion of Panama in 1989. This helicopter saw extensive service during the 1991 Gulf War and a humanitarian mission in Somalia in 1994. Since the September 11th attacks, Black Hawk helicopters have been deployed extensively in both Iraq and Afghanistan. The UH-60A is powered by two General Electric T700 GE701 turboshaft engines, each producing 1,560 shaft horsepower. Internal fuel totals 360 gallons and is stored in two crash-worthy fuel tanks. The Black Hawk can carry two 230-gallon external tanks and up to two additional auxiliary 185-gallon tanks internally in the cargo compartment, if equipped with ESSS. The Black Hawk can fly with just one engine. Modern UH-60 Black Hawk can cruise at speeds in excess of 174 miles per hour and climb at 1,315 feet per minute. The UH-60A is equipped with troop accommodations for 8, which can be removed to accommodate 4 full-size medical litters. The Black Hawk can transport 11 fully equipped combat soldiers in an assault-ready configuration, or 14 in a maximum capacity situation. Maximum troop carrying capacity is 20 lightly equipped personnel. The dedicated medevac variant of the Black Hawk can accommodate 6 litters. The UH-60A is equipped with a rearward sliding and lockable door on each side of the cargo compartment. The external cargo hook is rated to 8,000 pounds. The UH-60A does not have any dedicated weapon systems, but it does have two pintle mounts, one each located on either side of the airframe aft of the flight deck. The M60 GP 7.62mm machine gun, the M240 7.62mm machine gun, the 50 caliber GAU 19A machine gun, and the General Electric M134 7.62mm six-barreled minigun are all compatible with these pintles. The UH-60A can carry up to 16 Hellfire missiles, as well as 2.75-inch FFAR rocket pods, FIM-92 Stinger anti-air missiles, and aerial mine delivery systems, such as the Volcano and the M56 mine delivery system, using the ESSS system. The Black Hawks can take a lot of punishment, and they can operate in a lot of very tough environments. Whether it's sand or snow, hot or cold weather, they're really built to operate in tough terrain. The UH-60M is the latest iteration of the standard Black Hawk platform. Compared to earlier models of the Black Hawk, the UH-60M incorporates upgraded T700 GE701D engines, improved rotor blades, and avionics that include modern electronic instrumentation, flight controls, and aircraft navigation control. This airframe will continue to serve until the early 2030s, when it'll be replaced by the Bell V-280 Valor. The Bell V-280 Valor is the US Army's next-generation tilt-rotor aircraft, developed to replace the UH-60 Black Hawk as part of the Future Long-Range Assault Aircraft, or FLRAA, program. Designed to significantly enhance speed, range, and agility over existing helicopters, the V-280 showcases the latest advancements in tilt-rotor technology. It builds upon the legacy of Bell's earlier tilt-rotors like the XV-15 and the V-22 Osprey, but with improved efficiency and performance. The V-280 is designed for a top speed of 300 knots and a cruising speed of 280 knots, significantly faster than traditional helicopters. Its range is equally impressive, with a combat range of 500 to 800 nautical miles and a maximum ferry range of 2,100 nautical miles, making it well suited for long-range operations in contested environments. Unlike the V-22 Osprey, the V-280 features fixed-engine nacelles with only the rotors tilting, which helps reduce maintenance complexity and manufacturing costs while enhancing performance. With a maximum takeoff weight of around 30,000 pounds, the V-280 can transport up to 14 troops or carry external loads such as a 10,000-pound M777 howitzer. The aircraft's composite fuselage and single-piece wing structure contribute to weight reduction and structural strength, ensuring both durability and maneuverability. The V-280 is equipped with a triple redundant fly-by-wire system, which ensures enhanced control and reliability in both slow-speed and high-speed operations. Additionally, the V-280 offers greater operational flexibility with its advanced avionics and mission systems. These systems improve situational awareness for pilots in complex environments, enabling rapid troop deployment, medical evacuation, and even autonomous operations. The US Army is expected to begin fielding prototypes around 2025, with full operational capability anticipated by the 2030s. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the choppers of the US military. So, what do you think about these remarkable aircraft? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of the aircraft mentioned in this video up close, or better yet, flew one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.